Consider the ravens, for they need in the crop. They have no sources of water, and yet God feeds them. Mm. How much more valuable are you than the birds? Mm. And which of you, by worrying, can add an hour to his lifespan? Mm. So, if you're not even able to do the very little thing, such as that, then why are you worrying about this? Mm. Consider the lilies of the field and wildflowers. This, such as that, it says here. Consider the lilies of the field and the wildflowers, how they grow in the little open field. They neither labor nor spin. Yet, I tell you, not even Solomon in all his glory and splendor dressed himself in one of these. But if this is how God clothes the grass, which is in the field today and tomorrow, and is thrown into a furnace, how much more will it clothe you? Mm. You of little faith. So as for you, do not seek what you will eat or what you will drink, nor have an anxious or an unsettled mind. For all the pagan nations of the world greedily seek these things, and your heavenly Father already knows that you need them. But strive actively to seek his kingdom, and then all these things will be given unto you as well. So, from that passage that I've read to you, it was quite a lengthy one, but I needed to give you the passage I can explain to you. It says there, the first two verses that I gave you, God warns us of it and watching material possessions. And in verse 16 going down, he said Jesus shared this parable. How we live is an expression of faith. And this is what the world sees when they look at us. So we shouldn't be like the world. They think, I'll do things, and I'm doing it for myself, and I'm doing it on my own now. Because that's the program that we've been programmed with in this world. I'm going to make it. There's no God in the world. So God is saying to you, yes, you can die tomorrow. I'll take you. I'll take you out of this world, and then there's possessions will be here. You won't have it. But if you lean on me, and if you depend on me, and you make me the center of your life, I'm going to give you all things. I can give you this thing so much more.
Amen.
So, remember that God rewards our faith. A while ago, when I preached to you about the faith, I said, what sits in heaven is waiting for you to take. And in order for you to take, you need to build up your faith.
Amen.
You need to build up the word inside of you.
Amen.
And that is the ultimate purpose. That's the ultimate that God wants from us. Is to build ourselves up so that we can think that he has in store for us. But remember, we've been told this for 2 weeks. About the importance, and Pastor is so into that, the importance of tithing is a covenant that we said God is taking place, and he says, I can only give you that when you adhere to what I'm asking you, to my word, which says, you shall bring a tenth into the storehouse.
Amen.
So that I can open up the windows. So imagine those windows in heaven. There's waiting to be opened up. So we need to take that step of faith. Yes, it worked. I can't let it die. Believe me.
Amen.
But if you're consistent, God will show you his God will show you that he's faithful, that he will do that.
Amen.
And so much more. He'll surprise you with your little And that's how it's in the world. Remember, he's got an eternal God. It says, there's a scripture that says there's an inexhaustible world waiting for us. Not for when we die, for now.
Amen.
We need to access it now.
Amen.
So, We know that He is going to come through for us.
Amen.
If we keep our eyes on the Word, we know that He's going to keep us. So, I just want to give you a few scriptures. My video will end up. In 1 Corinthians 10, verse 26. If you wonder how great God's wealth is, this is one of the verses that will kind of like put it into a bit of a context. I say a bit, but I'm just trying to be. So first thing is 10 verse 26. In the Amplified it says, "For the whole earth is the Lord."
Amen.
And everything in it. In Proverbs, I'll go to Exodus 19 verse 5.
Amen.
You shall harvest and clear out the old because of the new. Think of it. All the old things are gone. He's going to give us new things.
Amen.
Is there any value?
No, it's just money.
Amen.
Wow. as you give your offering today, as you give your seed today, be cognizant of the fact that when I do diligently what God asks me to do, He's going to come.
Amen.
He's going to come.
Amen.
So, as I end back to Pastor, I want to just thank you for leaving me the opportunity to share.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Now imagine if she didn't think of giving me the laptop. Laptop was closed, she was not using it. But she said, Pastor, why should you use the laptop? And the day she gave me the laptop, that's the day also she checked on the emails. She activated the internet once she got the laptop. Then she found the police that was supposed to give us money. May God also connect you with us in the name of Jesus. Some of you guys told me to do certain things. You are just holding on, you are just holding on, you are just holding on. So you are missing your blessing. May God open you up in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So she said, put God first. Dear neighbor, put God first.
Put God first.
Say loud, put God first.
Put God first.
I cannot hear you.
Put God first.
I cannot hear you.
Put God first.
Say louder.
Put God first.
Again.
Put God first.
Put God first. So, let us all close our eyes. Just in that atmosphere where your eyes is closed. Just want to sing one song.
I see the goodness of your grace.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.